So let us start this day with the lecture 3, that is the continuation of lecture 2 that we have done yesterday. What we were discussing yesterday, if you recall, we looked at the solar radiation possibilities, we looked at how solar PV can be useful for fulfilling all our energy requirement. Then we actually are looking at the relative motion between sun and earth, so that we can find out at what angle we can collect the maximum solar radiation. Then we have also looked at that two facts, that the sun moves always in a plane which is tilted at an angle equal to the latitude angle. Okay, so the angle of the plane is fixed, and this plane, so I am talking about the day motion of the sun. So, morning and evening and afternoon. Sorry. So, the sun moves in a plane, but the position of the plane can change and depending on the day. So, there are days which are equinox, when the day length is equal to night length, and there are days which are solstice, where sun reaches to its extreme position either towards the southern hemisphere or towards the northern hemisphere. As a result of that, what we have seen that if you look at the horizontal ground, and if you are located at angle, so if this is normal to the ground, if you are located at some angle which is latitude angle called phi, okay, then this is going to be the motion of your sun. This is peak position of the sun in the afternoon. This is where it start, and the plane, the angle remains same, the position of the plane will change. Okay, so in the winter time, the sun will appear to have the motion in this plane, and therefore this angle is phi and this angle here is delta. Okay, I told you the delta is a declination angle. It is angle between the line joining the center of the sun to the center of earth with respect to the equatorial plane. Okay, sometime delta can be 0, sometime delta can be +23.45, sometime it can be -23.5. So, in extreme position like this here, okay, in extreme position here, the total angle with respect to normal, the total angle with respect to normal is phi plus delta. Okay, and the tilt of the panel, okay, suppose you are installing a panel, so your panel should be perpendicular to the rays, and particularly in the afternoon time. Why afternoon time? Because in the afternoon the radiation intensity is maximum, and you want to collect the maximum solar radiation at the afternoon. So, so if I want to make a solar panel perpendicular to this plane, okay, perpendicular to this plane, because the rays will be coming in this direction, then I have to install my panel like this. Okay, so this is my PV panel. Or for that matter, any solar collector. So, your water heater will also actually work on the same principle. Okay. Now, this angle I was measuring, phi plus delta is measuring with respect to normal, but we can measure this angle with respect to horizontal plane. Okay. So, this angle. So, this is the tilt with respect to the horizontal. Then I would say that and this is referred as a beta. Okay. This is referred as a beta. So, this angle is beta, which is a tilt of the collector. Tilt of the solar panel. So, beta is actually, you should have 90 minus, because I am this angle phi plus beta is with respect to perpendicular. So, I have to take 90 and subtract it. So, 90 minus phi plus delta, and I know that my delta can be plus or minus. So, this is then beta is equal to your tilt of the solar collector. For that matter, it can be solar photovoltaic or it can be solar thermal also, okay, or any other collector. And remember this, the whole equation is true for the noon time, okay, the peak position of the sun, peak position of the sun, because in the morning sun will be here, so your angle should be this, in the before and afternoon your sun will be here, so your angle should be this, but I am talking about the noon time. So, this is an angle beta equal to 90 minus phi plus minus delta. Phi is the latitude angle and delta is the declination angle. Okay, phi is the latitude angle, delta is the declination angle. So, this is what we have discussed so far yesterday, and let us continue our discussion to that. And we will come to this point also, that this tilt of the earth with respect to its line joining the center of the sun to the center of earth, the earth axis is tilted by 23.545 degree, and because of that there is a cause of season, summer and winter. So, for example, this line in the center is the equator, okay. This line at latitude 23.5 is the Tropic of Cancer, and this line below 23.545 south is a Tropic of Capricorn, okay. So, suppose you are living in a location at A, point A. If you are living in a location point A, which is at the Tropic of Cancer, so your latitude angle is 23.45 degree, right. This is the extreme position of the earth, and then the it will start moving in the other direction, okay. So, at this point, if you look at the sun, sun is directly overhead position, okay. In the afternoon, it will be directly at overhead position, okay, which means this point A will get the maximum radiation as compared to any other point on the earth surface, right. So, if you go above in the higher latitudes or lower latitudes, you are going to get lower radiation, okay. Now, the earth is revolving, and after 6 months it comes to this position, okay. So, it is revolving in this plane. So, after 6 months it is coming to this position. So, note here that this is the equatorial plane, okay. This plane, if I continue this line like this, this is the equatorial plane. Here the equatorial plane is here. So, if this is my line joining the center of the sun to center of earth, my equatorial plane in the one extreme position is like this, and in other extreme position it is like this, okay. So, this my, because of the tilt, right. Now, consider this position, same point A, Tropic of Cancer at 23.45 degree, same point, but this point in the same condition is not actually overhead. Your sun is not on top of you now in the afternoon condition. So, therefore, in this position here, the sun was a point A or location A was getting a high amount of radiation. So, it will be summer here, but at this point in this time 6 months later, the point A will get the lower amount of radiation even as compared to this point, because now this point is on the top. So, then this will become winter, okay. And that also you can understand how the angle of the sun rays is changing, okay. So, if your point A in this time, which is June 21st, what should be the tilt of your solar collector? At this point, what should be the tilt of your solar collector? Because the sun rays are coming exactly on the top, sun rays are coming exactly from the top. So, your collector has to be flat on the ground, okay. So, your collector has to be the flat on the ground. But in this location A, what should be the angle? Let me draw this situation 21st December winter on a whiteboard. So, if you are this situation, this is your line joining the center of the sun. So, this is your sun and earth. I will draw a little bit bigger so that it becomes clear, okay. Now, this is the tilt and this is your equator, okay. Okay, so this is your equator, this is your north, this is your south, and at 23.45 your Tropic of Cancer, and below 23.45 your Tropic of Capricorn, okay. So, now you are sitting at this point, okay, and this point is obviously not getting the enough radiation. So, now you want to get the maximum solar radiation, which will have this direction. So, your collector has to install at this angle, okay. Now, this angle will have actually this. So, you have to tilt by this angle, which will be sum of this angle will be sum of the angle between the line joining with the equator plane. This is 23.45 and this is another 23.45. So, you will actually have almost about 47 degree tilt. So, this angle will be about 47. So, remember that one position when the earth was on the other side, when the earth was at this side, the collector was making a zero angle, or the normal was aligned with the sun rays and your collector was flat on the ground. In the extreme position here, your collector has to be 47 degree. So, therefore, the angle of the collector will change from maximum 47 degree throughout the motion. So, this is what depicts here, that how the different position of the earth with respect to sun requires a different tilt of the module to collect the maximum radiation in the noon time, and the maximum variation in this tilt will be about 47 degree. So this has the various latitude and longitudes that is there in India. For example, the southest point is 8 degree latitude. You go to the north, it is about 35 degree north. Okay, the longitudes varies from 68 degree east to 96 degree. Just to be clear, so that whenever we talk about any location and we want to find out the angle of the PV module tilt, then we should know the latitude. Okay. One other thing that we should note here is that because we are in the northern hemisphere, the sun appears to us that it is always in a southern hemisphere. Okay. So one thing is you have to tilt your collector with respect to the, if this is a horizontal ground, you have to tilt your collector. But what is the position? Tilt is this direction or this direction? So this tilt, the face of the module should always be in the southern direction, because in the northern hemisphere, and opposite is true when you go to the southern hemisphere. So if you are putting your module in southern hemisphere, then the face of your module should be towards the north. If you are putting your modules in the northern hemisphere, then the face of your module should be towards the south. Okay, so same thing here that we already discussed, that this altitude angle, or the angle or the tilt of the module should be 90 minus phi plus minus delta here it should be. Okay, so now the declination angle that we are talking about, the declination angle changes throughout the year every day, and the equation is given 23.45 sine of 360 divided by 365 in the bracket 284 plus n. Okay. As we discussed yesterday, the n is the day of the year, n equal to 1 for January, n equal to 2 for January 2, n equal to 3 for January 31st, and n equal to 365 for December 31st. Okay. So here I have given some number, n equal to 335 for December 1. So just think quickly, what should be the n for June 21st? Okay. What should be the value of n? So which day of the year June 21st is, that is equal, that is your n. Think about it quickly, which day of the year June 21st is, what is the value of n for June 21st? Okay, so it is almost about the middle of the month, so it will have the value about 170 172. So precise calculation you can do. So now look at the variation of declination angle. Okay, the declination angle, as I said, on the equinox day, that the day length equal to night length, delta is 0. Delta is 0 means the equatorial plane is exactly in line with the line connecting the center of the sun to center of earth. So these 2 days, September 21st and March 21st, are the equinox day. These are the extreme position. Okay. So for example, in December, the sun, December 21st, sun goes to the extreme position. So extreme, what we call Dakshinayan in our Hindi calendar. And June 21st, it goes to the other side in the extreme position. Okay. So this is how the declination angle changes. It crosses 0 2 points, it reaches maximum value of minus 23.45 on December 21st plus 23.45 on June 21st. So this we need to calculate. So this is what I already discussed, that if I want to tilt my panel to collect the maximum solar radiation in the afternoon. And this is what I told, that most of the solar power plant in the country are designed, are installed in a way that they collect maximum solar radiation in the afternoon, because the intensity is higher in the afternoon. Okay. So we are interested now in beta, that is beta is the tilt of the module with respect to horizontal plane. Okay, so this is how we can calculate phi plus delta. But what is the problem now? Because my delta is changing every day, right? Remember, the delta is a function of n. Okay, n changes every day. So which means my delta changes every day. And if my delta changes every day, which means my tilt, that is beta, also changes every day. Beta changes every day means, so which means you have to tilt your module almost on a daily basis. So you have to tilt your module on a daily basis. Sorry, so I think earlier I told you the beta equal to 90 minus phi minus delta, but actually this is correct. The beta is 90 minus theta, that is the angle, and if I put, then beta is actually phi minus delta, or actually this should be phi plus minus delta, because delta can be plus or delta can be minus. Okay, so this is the tilt, beta equal to phi plus minus delta. So now because my delta keeps changing every day, my beta should also keep changing every day. So which is again a problem because I cannot tilt my modules on a daily basis. In practice it can be done, but it results in adding up the cost. It results that extra facility in your power plant to actually adjust the module. Or even if you are installing a power solar panel on a rooftop, you will have to actually do every day. Now that will become a problem. So then what we should do? Then we should actually take the average value of the delta, okay. So if I take an average value of delta, so this is how the delta is varying throughout the year. If I take an average value of delta, what it will be? So what do you think the average value of delta will be? So that is the area of the curve, positive side and negative side, okay. So because it is a symmetric curve, the average value of delta over a period of a year will be 0, okay. Now if you take a, so you said okay fine, so average value of delta over a period of a year will be 0, which means if your beta is equal to phi plus minus delta and delta average, okay, delta average is equal to 0 over a year, right. For the whole year if I take delta average is equal to 0, which means beta is equal to phi, very simple. What does it mean? That it means the tilt of your module should be equal to the latitude angle of the location, okay. So if I am in Mumbai, latitude angle of Mumbai is 19 degree, then the I should always put the modules at tilted at 19 degree. In which direction? So if I am putting my module with respect to ground at 19 degree, okay, at 19 degree. So this is my south and this is my north, okay. So module should always face towards the south. The module should always face towards the south. So this is the location, and but think about your location. So if you are in the southern, if you are in the down south, then your angle can be, you know, 8, 9 degree, 10 degree depending on the latitude. Or if you are in the further north, Delhi etc., then your angle will be about 23 degree, okay. So this is the thumb rule that if you want to just fix your collector for once and if you do not want to change throughout the year, then you should take the average value of delta. An average value of delta is 0 or the declination angle is 0, and therefore your beta, that is the inclination of your module, is equal to phi. So well, the case is very simple, but then you are going to lose some amount of radiation, right, because you know, if you are fixing at this angle, you know, in the summer your sun will be on the top here, so you are not collecting maximum. In the winter your sun will go here, so you are not collecting maximum radiation. So therefore some people what they do is that, okay, let us, I cannot change the tilt of a module every day, but let me change the tilt of module once in a month, okay. So if you want to change the tilt of a module once in a month, what you should do? Take the average monthly value of the delta. What you should do? Take the average monthly value of the delta, okay. So then the average monthly value of the delta for summer will be a positive, for winter it will be a negative. So then you can answer this question yourself. What should be the fixed collector inclination in summer? What should be the solar water heater inclination in the summer? Okay. Now when you are actually trying to install a solar water heater, in the summer you don't want so much hot water, but you want more hot water in the winter, and therefore you should optimize your tilt for the winter. Okay. And because the sun is more in the southern hemisphere, tilt is more in the southern hemisphere, you should actually tilt your module more for the winter location, okay. And in winter, and what happens in winter? So equal to beta equal to phi minus delta, and the delta itself is a delta, can be either plus or minus, okay. So if I am taking winter situation, then I have negative value of delta. So then I have to have minus, and then I have to put negative value of delta, which is in winter December, for example, it can be minus 23.45. Then I will actually phi plus 23.45 degree. So basically, if you are installing your module for winter, if you want to make a highest generation or highest collection of solar radiation for the winter case, then and the extreme winter, then you have to add 23.45. So as a result, that is why you will see that when you look at the solar water heater, the angle of the solar water heater is normally more than the angle of solar PV panels, right? Because In solar water heater, you want to maximize your collection in the winter, while for the solar PV panel, you might want to maximize your collection in the summer because you want more electricity. Okay, but otherwise, if you say that if you are ready to change the angle every, if you are ready to change the angle or the inclination angle every month, then you should take a average value of, you should take an average value of delta, and that average value will change. Okay, so therefore, so this we already discussed that average delta is 0 over the year, therefore beta equal to phi, but otherwise beta average inclination should be phi minus delta, and the delta by the way is already taking care of the plus and minus sign. So I hope it is clear to all of you now that depending on the case when you want to maximize the collection, you can actually decide the tilt and do the inclination of your collector accordingly, and this applies to both solar water heater and a solar PV panel. Okay, so this is a comparison that I shown here, that normally this horizontal line here is the case when you are installing your module at the latitude angle. Okay, you are fixing, you are not changing any time. So this is the horizontal line. Now you suppose you are changing the tilt every month, then what will happen? So suppose you are changing the tilt, if you are making it latitude minus 15, then you will say that this line will follow latitude minus 15. So now latitude is minus 15 for the June, July, you are going to get more collection, right. So if you want your generation to be more, and this is still case of the fixing, right. So you are fixing it, but you are not fixing it to the latitude angle, but if you are fixing it to the latitude minus 15 degree on an average, and therefore your collection will be better in June and July. But look at the other case, that is latitude plus 15. Okay, latitude minus 15 means what? Latitude minus 15 means actually if this is the latitude angle, you are actually putting at minus 15, which is putting it more, trying to put it more horizontal. Okay, but if you are saying latitude plus 15 means if this is the normal angle, then you are actually trying to put it more towards the south, more tilt. Okay, so this is phi plus 15 degree case, and this is phi minus 15 degree case. Okay, so because in the summer the sun almost comes to the overhead position, so this will give you more generation in summer. Okay, so this is suitable, this setting is suitable for summer, and this setting, because sun goes south, okay, sun goes down in the south direction in winter, and therefore this setting will be more suitable for winter location, winter season. So that is what is shown here in this graph. Okay, so this was so far simple. What we have discussed was simple because we are talking about one position of the sun, that is afternoon position, right. So all our this discussion so far is about the position of the sun at the noon time, right. But actually the angle made by the sun with respect to the solar rays at any given time on a same day are different. Okay, so for example, if this is your module, okay, this is your module, they installed. Now sun moves in a plane. Okay, suppose the sun is moving in a plane like this. So this is the afternoon position, this is the morning position, this is the before noon and afternoon position. Okay, so now look at the angle that is made. Okay, so now you normally you actually incline your module for the afternoon position. So in the afternoon, this is the normal to the panel. So the normal to the panel, the angle is perfectly 90 degree here, and this is what we want, that rays should be perpendicular to this. Okay, but look at the morning position. Okay, so morning angle is not optimal, the rays will come from this direction, then it will come from this direction, it will come from this direction, then it will come from this direction. Okay, so the if you are fixing a module, then of course you design it for the afternoon position, but if you are not fixing your module position, then actually you want to collect the good radiation in the morning also, you want to collect good radiation at 9 o'clock also, you want to collect the good radiation at 10 o'clock also, and so on. And your job is always to make sure that the solar radiation is always perpendicular to the solar panel. Okay, in that case you are collecting maximum radiation. So then it is called the trekking. Okay, then basically you have to follow this angle. So in the when it is morning, you have to make your module like this. When it is 9 o'clock, you have to make module perpendicular to this rays. When it is 12 o'clock, you make your module perpendicular to this rays. Okay, so basically it means that your solar radiation, the angle of the solar radiation falling on the solar panel depends on other parameters also, right? So few things are very clear to us. So let me repeat. Now we are thinking about following the sun every minute, every second. Okay, so far earlier discussion was only to fix a module so that you can get a better collection at the afternoon, but now we are thinking that all the time I should get a better collection. So there are many parameters, and this is actually a long topic, and what I have told you so far is good enough, and we will not go into the details of this, but just to give a brief introduction that if you really want to calculate the angle that sun ray is making with respect to the normal to the plane, okay, with respect to the normal to the plane, look at here, what is the normal? This green line is the normal to the plane, okay, and this is the sun position here. So this angle theta, this angle theta between the normal to the plane and the sun ray is what is important, and you want what is the value of theta you want? This angle theta here is the angle between the normal to the plane and sun rays, okay. What do you want the value of this angle? This angle should be 0 all the time, okay, morning, afternoon, evening, before noon, afternoon, summer, winter, any time. If you want maximum collection, the angle theta, that is the angle between normal to the plane and the sun ray, should be 0, okay. So now we should see how theta depends on other angles, okay. So look at what are the other angles. First of all, the beta, which is the tilt of the module, is one of the important angle, okay, fine. This is the angle which is called the gamma, which is the, if you take a due south, okay, angle between the due south or the angle between the due south direction and the projection of the normal to the plane with respect to the due south, okay. So basically with respect to south, how is your panel, right? So if your panel is exactly looking south, then the gamma is 0, okay. If your sun rays is in the morning in the east, suppose this is east, okay, if sun rays are here and your panel is looking this way, so you are making a 90 degree with respect to that, okay. In the evening, sun will go the other side and you will make a 90 degree, but the sign will be different, okay. So that is called gamma, okay. So that is orientation of the plane, okay, that gives gamma. What are the other factors that will change your value of theta? The factor that will change the value of theta is the latitude of the location, okay. So depending on the location, that will change. Day of the year, your declination also changes the angle, right, because declination defines the how down the sun is or how up the sun is in the sky in the afternoon. So that is your declination angle, that will determine the angle. Time of the day, we are talking about 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, 12 o'clock or the morning, and the beta and gamma already discussed, okay. So the theta, which you always want to be 0 when you are completely following the sun, will depend on the 5 different angles. And this angle latitude can vary plus minus 90, so you can go to 90 degree north and 90 degree south. Surface azimuth angle, or the orientation of the panel, okay, surface azimuth angle is this angle by the gamma with respect to south, due south, where is the sun rays, that can vary 360 degrees, so one side 180 degree, other side 180 degree, okay. Our angle, basically the time is given, the time is given in terms of the angle, okay. So in a one day there is a 360 degree rotation, so 360 divided by 24 hours, so basically you will get 15 degree per hour rotation, okay. So the time of the day is measured in terms of angle, because we are all talking about the angles here. So 12 o'clock is considered 0 hour angle, and 11 o'clock will be a 15 degree minus 15 degree hour angle, 10 o'clock will be minus 30 degree hour angle. If you go to the afternoon time, it is positive. So 12 o'clock is 0 hour angle, 1 o'clock is plus 15 degree hour angle, 2 o'clock is plus 30 degree hour angle, and so on. So, 6 o'clock is minus 90 degree in the morning, and 6 o'clock in the evening is plus 90 degree. slope of the surface at the collector can be 0 or 180. Okay, 0 means it is lying flat on the ground. So with respect to ground, the angle of the panel is 0. So it's lying flat on the ground, and 90 degree means your panel is vertical. And the declination angle, as I said, can vary -23.45 to +23.45. Okay, so these are the various angles that can vary. And I'll come to back to this slide, but I just want to give an idea that, and we are not going to look at the details of this calculation. I just want to give it an idea that if you know the theta, if you know the theta, you can find out the intensity of the light falling on your surface. So here, so IB cos theta is the intensity of the light falling on your collector. Now this value of theta, cos, the value of theta that we are interested, is a function of all these angles, and here is the simple equation that you can get, or rather complicated equation. So the value of angle that sun rays makes with the normal to the plane, which is theta. Okay, so this angle depends on so many other angles. There are 5 angles. So there is phi, delta, beta, gamma, and omega. So the simple or the equation is this. And if you can find out each angle at any given time, at any given day, at any given location, at any given tilt of the collector, you can find out what is the angle of the sun rays with respect to normal. And remember, what we want to do, we want to make this angle theta as low as possible and preferably 0. So when you are doing the sun tracking, actually you can feed this formula in your microcontroller, and your microcontroller will calculate all this angle and will exactly align your panel perpendicular to the sun rays all the time. All the time means morning to evening, all the season, summer and winter, all the location, equator and the northern side or the southern side, etcetera. Okay. This is extra. Somebody wants to learn more about the radiation, so I am just giving you few slides, and when you have time after this course, you can actually go through this solar radiation and actually use these equations to estimate the amount of solar radiation available at a given location. And this is estimation only, because the exact measurement requires long time, so many people actually estimate. Okay. So I very quickly go through the slide, but don't worry, you are not supposed to learn this. Our main job here is to find out how much amount of the solar radiation and how to incline a module for a year or a month or so. So these are the various equations that are there, that are used in this estimation of the solar radiation. You have to find the hour angle, you have to do the various calculations. When you do all these calculations, you can actually find out the solar radiation. Okay, this is the main formula. And again, please do not worry about this. I'm just giving you this extra information in case anybody want to learn more about the solar radiation. This is also discussed in my book, which is given to all the participants. So when you have time after this course, you can go through this slides and learn more about the radiation. But because we have to, this is a PV course and we do not have enough time, so we cannot afford to go through all these slides. Fine. So let me come back to the solar radiation. Okay. So so far we have learned that, okay, if I want to install my collector at a fixed angle throughout the year, I don't want to change, then it is equal to the latitude angle. It should be south facing. But if I want to maximize it for the summer, then it is latitude -15 degree I should install. If I want to maximize the collection in the winter, then it is a latitude +15 degree I should install. Or if I want to maximize at a given month, then I should take a average value of the delta declination angle for that month, and then I should take proper care for the sign plus or minus and 8 to the phi and get the tilt. When we are talking about solar radiation, solar power plant, solar PV system, we should always know what is the available fuel for us. Okay, available fuel is basically solar radiation. The solar radiation is now given in a various ways, represented in various ways. What are the ways? Solar radiation, or many times it is also referred as insolation, solar insolation, for a given location is given on hourly basis. Many times you do not need hourly basis. It can be given on a daily basis. Okay, so solar radiation, when you say daily basis means basically it's a total solar radiation energy falling on a given day, which means you are actually integrating the total energy from morning to evening. Okay, so basically when you are integrating means you are talking about the energy available, solar radiation energy available per day. You can integrate over a month, so you can get the monthly solar radiation energy available, and you can integrate of course over the year. So this is one way of doing it, per hour, per month, per year. Other way of talking about the solar radiation is whether it is a diffuse radiation, direct radiation or a global radiation. Okay, so you should know that whether the radiation given is diffuse, direct or global, fine. Other way of saying is whether the solar radiation is given in terms of the direct normal solar radiation. Okay, so always direct normal means normal to the sun rays, always, always normal to the sun rays. So if your collector is here, then you are talking about this. So sun rays basically is angle of the sun rays changes all the time. So you are actually collecting the radiation all the time perpendicular to the sun rays, and that is referred as a direct normal solar radiation. Direct normal solar radiation is particularly useful for concentrator technology, because your concentrator optics can only concentrate the light which is coming perpendicular to the plane, okay, or the parallel rays only. So therefore many concentrator technology, particularly like concentrator solar thermal technology, will require knowledge of DNI, direct normal insolation. The normal global insolation will not do the job. Solar radiation can also be given in terms of the radiation, whether it is at horizontal plane or the radiation with respect to some other plane, right. So because as we discussed that your solar modules are installed normally not on the horizontal plane, okay, not flat on the ground, okay, normally they are inclined at some angle, right. So rather than knowing the solar radiation on the horizontal plane, it is more important to know the solar radiation at a inclined plane, okay, so that will give the correct picture, right. So solar radiation can be represented in many ways, and we have to be careful while using the information. Fine. So let me go through again. So it can be daily basis, hourly basis, monthly basis, yearly basis. It can be a diffuse, direct, global. It can be a direct normal. It can be a solar radiation on the horizontal plane or at any other given plane. And that the theta, the complicated equation of theta that I have showed you, actually if you can use that equation, you can find out any radiation that you want. Okay. So when we say solar radiation, when you say instantaneous value of solar radiation, it is given, remember, as a given as a, as we were discussing yesterday, the solar constant. What was the unit of solar constant? Instantaneous value of the radiation, okay. The instantaneous value is watt per meter square, right. And we also discussed that air mass 0, okay. So instantaneous value, air mass 1.5, we discussed yesterday that it is 1000 watt per meter square, okay. So this is watt per meter square, okay. This is instantaneous value, but when we are talking about the daily or hourly or monthly solar radiation, then we are actually talking about the integration of this instantaneous value over that period, right. So we are talking about daily solar radiation means we have to integrate the instantaneous value of solar intensity throughout the day, and once we integrate, basically what we are doing, we are multiplying with the time. And when we multiply with the time, what you will get? What you have to get in multiply with hour, right. So when you are multiplying with hour, this your watt per meter square will become watt hour per meter square, okay. And typically this are presented in kilos, so kilowatt hour. So solar radiation value can easily be the radiation energy, I would say, is given in terms of kilowatt hour per meter square. And then depending on this case, it can be per meter square per day, it can be per meter square per month, it can be per meter square per year, okay. So the daily solar radiation can be kilowatt hour per meter square per day, monthly kilowatt hour per meter square per month, and yearly kilowatt hour per meter square per year, okay. Typically in India, the solar radiation varies between 4 to 7 kilowatt hour per meter square per day, okay, 4 to 7 kilowatt hour per meter square per day. And if you multiply by 365, you will say that solar radiation value varies from 1400 to 2500 kilowatt hour per meter square per year. This is a very good amount of solar radiation, by the way. Okay, that is why you might have heard several times now that India is blessed with the solar radiation, okay, because our radiation intensities are very good, and because your fuel density is higher, your energy per unit area per unit year is higher, then your cost of electricity in India is lower than the cost of solar electricity in Europe, for example, right, because your fuel is higher. So this is an example of the solar intensity, average solar intensity for India. I don't know if you can read this, but the darker side here represents about over 6 kilowatt hour per meter square per day, okay, 6 to 6.5. This lighter yellowish side represent here about 5 kilowatt hour per meter square per day, okay. This is very low intensity, 4.5 kilowatt hour per meter square per day. But in general, if you look at the overall country, you will see that the solar radiation in general is pretty good, and it is between 4 to 7, but more or less it is between 4.5 to 6 kilowatt hour per meter square per day. Okay. You can also look at the world map. Okay. So this is in terms of the per day, but as I say, an annual solar radiation, if you look at in India, will vary between about 1400, 1500 kilowatt hour per meter square per day to about 2500 kilowatt hour per meter square per day. Remember, these numbers are very important, because when we are doing the solar PV system design, you should know that what is the daily radiation, or what is the monthly radiation, or what is the yearly radiation. If you do not know the precise number, at least you should have the idea about how much is the solar radiation variation, because you are going to use this number in our calculation, in your tutorial also. So remember these numbers. So we can similarly have the world map that I have shown you yesterday, but I can have a look at today also. So similarly, in the world, the solar radiation varies from very low values of 500 kilowatt hour per meter square per year, by the way, these numbers are per year, and then it can be as high as 2500 kilowatt hour per meter square per year. Okay. So India is somewhere here, and this belt, which is the equatorial belt, as you can see, receives a lot of solar radiation. So as I told yesterday also, that there is a plenty of sunshine that is available, and if you use very small fraction of it, that all normally is good enough to generate all our energy requirement. So with this, I would like to stop this discussion on the solar radiation. I hope it has given you a very brief idea about the solar radiation, how it varies. It has particularly given the idea about how to install a solar PV module, particularly when you are installing the module fixed, you are not tracking it. When you are installing module at a fixed angle, then how to calculate that angle for a optimum for a given month or a given year. So you can actually calculate the value of delta and find out that angle. Okay, we also learn the motion of the sun in a given plane, and that plane keeps on changing depending on the day, and the day is represented by angle delta, which can be calculated. Okay, so with this brief discussion, I'm sure that if I ask you to find out what should be the tilt of a solar panel on, let's say, March 31st to get a maximum solar radiation in the afternoon, I'm sure you should be able to do that. Okay, so be ready with that kind of problems. Solve your problems, and very, very simple. You need to know just phi and delta, and you can discuss with your colleagues and find out that what is the solar PV module tilt for a year, if you want to fix it for a year for your own location, for whatever village or city you are coming, you can do that calculation for the same, and it is going to be a simple calculation. Okay, fine. So let me take the question. Amrita Coimbatore.
Sir, the position of the sun is varying over year. So if we want to find the incline angle, is there any statistical method to calculate that?
Yes,
I want to generalize that angle.
Yeah, generalization is not possible, you know, because your latitude is different for different locations. So there cannot be a single angle, and it will vary with the latitude. So if you go in the south, your latitude angles are very small. If you go to the north, your latitude angles are large. If you go to Europe, your latitude angles are even higher. So therefore, you cannot generalize, and also your delta value changes every day. Okay, but so you have to take a delta phi and delta into account. But in general, you have to keep orientation towards the south, and if you are fixing your module for the whole year, then the angle is equal to the latitude angle. But as I said, you can optimize your collection either for the summer or for the winter. Okay, if you are optimizing your collection, if you want more collection in the summer, then you should have the latitude angle minus 15 degree. If you want more collection in the winter, then you have latitude angle plus 15 degree. But generalization is not possible. These two parameters you must take into account.
Sir, you have said that during the tilt of the earth, the angle that is 23.5 degree, is that angle is same, sir, anywhere?
So 23.45 degree is an angle which is the extreme position of the plane, equatorial plane, with respect to the line joining the center of the sun to the center of earth. Okay, but yeah, it and that is the extreme position. At any given location, that angle will change between plus 23.45 to minus 23.45. So total variation in that angle will be 47 degree. And at any given location on earth, that total variation in the angle will always be 47 only. Whether it is equator or any north or any south, the total variation is always be 47 degree. Okay, NIT Surat.
Basically, I am a designer of wind solar hybrid system, and in our hybrid configuration we don't have a good wind during winter. So sir, it is advisable to have the angle as per the solar water heater for solar PV panel. Can you throw some light on that?
For the wind you are talking about?
No, not for wind turbine, sir. See, for best consistency we do the hybrid of wind solar. Mm-hmm. And in that, the solar angle I think should be just like that of water heater. Mm-hmm. During winter, because in winter the wind is having a slack season, and during summer wind is good, even in monsoon it is good.
Yeah.
So can you throw some light on that?
Yeah, so you're very correct that because your wind is low in the winter, and you want more collection, you want your panel to produce more power for you in winter, and if you do not want to change the angle of your panels, then the best tilt for your panel will be that of corresponding to latitude angle plus 15 degree. Okay, and that is what normally solar water heater do, right? They collect maximum in winter, and yeah, what you are saying is true, that it has to be latitude angle plus 15 degree. Okay, one last question I'll take from Baramati.
Is there any mechanical sun tracking system instead of microcontroller?
Yes, there are mechanical sun tracking system people have designed, which is based on, for example, heating up a fluid, and or it is similar to what is the time machine that we have seen, the time machine. So there are systems people have installed, but actually because of the low cost and the more accuracy of electronic system, normally for the sun tracking people go for electronic system. But definitely it is possible to have the mechanical system also. There are many Schaeffler discs people use for the solar cooking, where they use arrangement of similar to what we have, the arrangement of the clock. In the old clock, you see that where the pendulum is using to maintain the time, that kind of arrangement is possible. So yes, mechanical tracking is also possible. Okay, KG Somaya, Mumbai.
Is it true that in India, Kutch receives maximum amount of solar radiation, which can generate electricity, which is sufficient for the whole country?
Yeah, definitely it is true, and based on the numbers that I have given you, you can yourself calculate the area now. I have told you that yesterday, if you remember, I told that if we just cover a 100 kilometer by 50 kilometer area of a of any Kutch region, for example, that will be sufficient to generate the whole electricity that India is generating today. Okay, and now we are using only 100 by 50 square kilometer, and typically the area of the Kutch is much more. Okay, so I think you all participants can also do the same calculation. Assume that your solar radiation is, let's say, 2000 kilowatt hour per meter square per year. Okay, take a 10% efficiency of that, then you will find out that you will have 200 kilowatt hour per meter square per year. That is the energy that you can generate, right? Now you divide whatever is your energy requirement. If your energy requirement is, you know 100 or 1000 billion units, that is 1000 billion kilowatt hour, divide it by 200 kilowatt hour per meter square, you will get the area of your module in meter square, right? So any participant should be able to do this calculation. It is very simple calculation, how much area is required to generate a given amount of energy. Okay, so do this calculation on your own and you will find precisely how much area is required. I mean, this is the for the country, but you can see, okay, only in Mumbai. For Maharashtra, if you want to generate your electricity, then how much area of the Maharashtra is required. Okay, some people can do it for Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, etc. So this is a simple calculation, you should be able to do yourself. Okay, so let me stop here. Thank you.